Hello viewers, I'm SB and welcome back to the Curious Expedition. So, we're pretty heavily specced for desert work now. And we do have a desert available here, but I see Mission Village Village. Basically, not exactly what I'm looking for. We do have another desert over here with a burial tomb, which means a mummy, and that would be great. But I think we're actually going to go to the Unforgiving Water Temple's grasslands. That name is horrible, just absolutely terrible. Because we had one of these not too long ago. I'm pretty sure. And I really, really, really want to hit 5 temples in one mission, basically. Temples often have like 120 fame worth of things in them. Because usually you get a thing that's worth 70 and a thing that's worth 50. And I think we need to do something like this to catch up. So I know this is not taking advantage of all of our desert skills, but the payout for this is huge. And we found that mysterious box, and we will totally hand it over. Absolutely. Thank you for the funds. A military chap approached me and spoke of a deserter who had abandoned his post. I would be suitably rewarded if I could bring him back to civilization. I will try. Let's give that a go. Pretty happy with my party. Battlecat. And this guy. Yeah, no thanks. We're good. So let's see what equipment we have access to. Another hunting rifle I don't think is necessarily the thing that we're looking for. How much alcoholism do we have in the party? Oh yeah, all of it. Fair enough. So this black market thing has been okay. I'm pretty pleased with it so far. I kind of want to bring this. Well, we definitely want to improve the camel's capacity. The question really is just, do we want to do it twice? Because we could afford to do it twice. I'm going to bring a shovel. Our fun balance is in a weird place because first aid kits cost a weird amount. So with 150 resources, I'm going to do this. Yeah. With 150 resources, we can double upgrade the camel. We're just going to take everything we can carry, basically. Capacity and capacity. Check out that saddle. All right. So what we're mostly concerned with is finding all of those temples. A stone circle or something would be fantastic. How did this happen? What, did the sea fall into a chasm behind us? After weeks of nasty food and seasickness, we arrived at our expedition area. We had arrived and it was time to sally forth. Yeah. So nobody thinks this is weird, huh? Okay. I'm willing to roll with it. Alright, so it's going to be watery here. That might have been a good clue for us to bring some ropes. But you know what? Okay, if we were going to find a village, this is when we wanted to. And hey, look at that. A man in a British officer's uniform welcomed us to his village. It's Lieutenant Conrad. We'll try to escort him home. I suspect he's not going to be cool with it. He assured us that he would not be coming with us. Hey, part of you's coming with us. Fierce Claws. Oh my god, Battlecat, you are amazing. Plus sanity, plus standing. This has been a very good start. Alright, I would like, actually, these things. What can I give to you? I can trade you some whiskey. Yeah, we'll take a mango on top of it. Sounds good. And then we will rest in the village. Later that night, Captain Robert Ninnis approached me with a request. He had fallen in love with one of the natives and asked for my permission to leave our trek and stay with his beloved. Nah, man. Bring her along, though. Yeah, let's go for it. Got hand. I have decided to steal their idol statue instead of regaining sanity. And then we will eat this. We did want to eat the mango right away anyway, because the mangoes go bad immediately. Okay, he's mad, so we'll give him a little shot of whiskey that'll clean his attitude up. Alright. Let's see what's over here. The first of many. Yes, yes, liquor. Here, have some loyalty. Jesus. Well, yeah, let's go ahead and examine the shrine. We can probably make this, and if we fail, it's just a wound. Yeah, let's go for it. We didn't make it. Take a wound. Whatever, it's fine. I should have known better. Captain Robert Ninnis almost reached the top when his foot slipped and fell, suffering a nasty head injury. Ow. Ooh. Tome page of world creation and a golden amulet. Okay. Continue. So, we have a couple of options here. Oh no, we don't. We have one realistic option. There's no reason for us to have that much water, basically. Do I want to just level him? Yeah, I don't think I want to save it. Okay, he gained a green die. I don't think I want to save it. I think it's a good idea. Yep, and then obviously we brought on the water. I mean, the whole place is going to flood anyway. Hey, mummies! Two mummies. Okay. Now we actually have to make some decisions. Well, I guess we'll just red mushroom this. Ah, but he's become superstitious. I was thinking, hey, let's use the red mushroom because it's slightly lower in value than the first aid kit, but it does tend to make you crazy, doesn't it? Okay. So then we have to divest ourselves of the other stack of water. Oh, hurry. Oh, hurry. Okay. So, what does this do? Okay, it does nothing right now. It creates a new expedition for us to go to, I'm sure. Totally fine with it. I was really expecting to find more things to fight. You know, it seems like stuff's more aggressive as you go on. Okay, here's some stuff we can fight. We learned that we gotta be careful of elephants. Oh wait, maybe the tome page of world creation is doing something. So what is this? This is a giant crab. We don't want to fight that. This is panthers. We can fight panthers for sure. Let's go see what this question mark is. So actually, yeah, the tome page of world creation seems to have had a tremendous effect on the terrain. Alright, we'll explore this campsite. What do we find? Bunch of machetes. Alright. I would really like to hold on to those, actually. Alright, this will help. Well, Battlecat's going to give him the claws. And then we kick it. And then we roll anything that does damage. Yeah, we're actually quite formidable. So this will help with our little item slots problem right there. And then, man, maybe I do just want to toss the machetes. Because I don't really want to toss any of this other stuff. And maybe the shovels? Yeah, the shovels are least likely to be useful. So let's go grab this butterfly. What is this? Hyenas. Well, that's just free sanity. Only two of them, even. So Fierce Claws, Battlecat one-shots one of them. Because he's the best. There, easy. Every time we fight, we gain quite a bit of stamina. Or sanity, rather. Keep doing that. I think we would rather save the hyena pelts than the panther pelt just because we have more of them. We could take that gorilla. Let's see how he moves. Okay, we're not actually finding a lot of these temples. Ooh, that's useful. And that is loot that doesn't take up an extra thing. And Lorette Cotillard has become superstitious. Hey, gorilla. Okay, so this is effectively 4 damage immediately, and then another 2 damage if the thing... if the thing survives. So we should definitely apply Fierce Claws. There's no reason to not do that. I'd like to save this. I actually would like to roll over to Fierce Claws on this. Okay, so... let's go Aim Shot... oh, I think it's sword and then man to do the AoE blast. And you have 8 health. So let's save all of these. Okay. Can't test my theory. Let's actually do a quick shot, and then on this one, we'll kick and kick. And then we'll eat some damage. Not Battlecat! Even got stunned. Just not good enough, I'm afraid. No, we definitely don't do that. We want to make aggressive plays here. I should have held, actually. He has 6 health. Oh no, we're actually fine. Because this is 3, and then this is 1, and then this is 2. Loot. That is 4 gorilla paws, which are worth a tremendous amount. So let's drop this. And I actually don't need to cook the meat right away for sanity purposes. I don't want to use the medkit on one of them and then have the other one get infected. Let's drop the torches. We're doing very well, though, on loot, which is exactly what needed to happen. Alright, so we'll wait to see if any wounds get infected before we... oh, this is exactly what I was looking for. Yep, that's the thing we were looking for. Alright, and then it looks like the... alright, the pyramid is still kind of murky. Alright, so we just have to not get caught in the erupting geysers, basically. Alright, so we'll watch as we approach. We have a ton of loyalty increasers, or sanity increasers. Let's go straight south. Okay, we're safe. We're safe. We're safe. Let's make sure that we're taking a sane route here. Actually, we don't want to move to here. We want to move to there. So let's eat some meat so that we can afford to do that. We're going to have to find some whiskey soon or something. Okay. Actually, things are probably going to get a little hairy inventory-wise here, so let's just eat all of the meat that we have left. Alright, and this thing says that the... oh, it must be like way up here, because we've got a lot of visibility on the land. Shoot, so it's really far away. Alright, well, let's examine the shrine. A layer of sand seemed to surround the structure. I'm not happy about... okay, we did make the die roll. I'm not happy about this being a climbing shrine. Fate smiled upon us. After some effort, we scaled the shrine without considerable problems. So let's... okay, take that stuff. Let's examine this other shrine. Could these not all be climbing shrines, maybe? That would be okay. Ooh, the golden dagger. So we don't... What am I going to do? What do I not carry with us? Because we have a lot of loot here. Let's go ahead and use this just to gain an inventory slot. Not that we really even needed to. And then drop the animal teeth, maybe? We're definitely not dropping our guns, and everything else in our inventory is really valuable. I think maybe we should bail. I think that was enough. We like can't really afford to carry anymore. So the question is, in which direction do we bail? Because we're actually going to run out of sanity here. We kind of need to get to and murder this elephant. I know, elephants, dangerous. But I don't see us getting out of here any other way. We need the sanity boost from fighting an animal. It's going to be rough. Go, guys, go. Go quickly. Oh, the water. Oh, the water. Just keep running. Okay. I canceled our travel while we still had a little bit of sanity left, but this could get really bad. Shoot, we got an event. Oh no, you asshole, you dropped the quest item. Alright, we have to kill the elephants. I know, it's a bummer. Nobody's excited about it, but especially since it's actually, I'm trying to make it sound like it's really trivial to do, but it's absolutely not. Alright, well, let's keep this and this and roll again. Kick. We might die, actually, from doing this. This might kill me. Okay, so I didn't roll another red face, so we should just do this. And then Fierce Claws, obviously. Quick Shot. And Ripper Leap. Okay, and that's one elephant down, so we only have to endure one set of attacks here. Hurts. We'll be okay. Fierce Claws. Roll again. Okay, so let's figure this out. I definitely want to do this. Aim shot. We'll point blank him. We'll kick him. He has 7 health left. I think this is actually the best we're going to get out of these 2 green dice. And then this is fine. Whatever. Alright, so we have a little shielding. Oh, the stomp. Oh, the AoE stomp, it hurts. Bite him. Shoot. Okay. 8 meat. That is wonderful. We are actually going to get to go back to full sanity. We failed our quest due to sanity loss, which I am not happy about. But everything, we're going to be alright. We'll be alright. So, it's like over here. I notice villagers are pursuing us at quite a rate. I do not like our chances against giant crab, but we might be able to... Nope. Ah, shoot. Can we just run away from it, like, a lot? Let's do that. Let's run away from it a lot. It's probably not faster than we are. It seems to be almost exactly as fast as we are, which is, in fact, not faster. Oh, hey, look. It's the way out and also angry villagers. Well, they're going to wish they hadn't attacked us. Oh, come on. I don't... All right. Well, this is a 3 damage multi-attack. That's pretty significant. And then we do this to finish you off. Oh no, that doesn't Because I can't math. Yeah, this guy is more dangerous. Alright, I think we won't take damage here. Yeah, we have too much shielding for them to get through. Battlecat. Battlecat is fantastic. I'm so happy about Battlecat. The mangoes will spoil right away, so we may as well use them. And then, I don't know. We can just leave and keep the red mushroom in our inventory, and I think that's what I'm going to do. We'll just travel overburdened for one space. Whew. Alright, after such an endeavor, euphoria overcame me. I knew that the name Freya Stark would go down in the annals of world history. I feel really good about that. I think that's going to put us right back in game-winning position. Battlecat is spectacular. Him being able to roll two different 6-damage dice so frequently is really awesome. I'm really excited when I get, like, that rifle combo off, rifle II, and do 4 damage per die. So, 6 damage per die is pretty incredible. I think we're gonna take Heavy Carrier. I do like reduced base sanity cost. It's not huge, but it's a thing that's always useful. So that's nice. We're gonna sell a lot of this stuff. So sell all of these. And then gift these things for sure. Gift the butterfly collection. Sell these. And gift all 3 of these things. And there we go. We have a healthy lead over the next place competitor and 350 funds. Those are totally worth it. And now, at this point, I think back to the desert with us. The Lunatic Desert. I did notice that there is a, there's a shrine here, or a temple, rather. And I like temples a lot, but we're good at the desert. Let's hit the desert. We don't have anything really driving us off. We lost 50 fame because of sanity. This guy wants us to steal an idol from a native settlement. Will do. We don't want to change up the crew. Things are going really well. Purchase equipment. Whiskey. Have to buy all the whiskey because my crew is crazy. Just go mad for whiskey. I probably don't need 5 dynamite. I do actually want to bring enough medical supplies for a change. Let's bring some dynamite. A couple of shovels in case we find a treasure map or something. But really the question is, do I do this and then buy another saddle upgrade? Is this enough gear to get us through? And actually, I think the answer is probably yes. Boy, I sure hope nothing bad happens to this camel. Alright, let's get back out there. I feel super, super great about that 3rd expedition. That was beautiful. The 2 mummies thing was just, like, what a stroke of good luck. Alright, definitely remember to take water. In fact, we have so much inventory space that I'm going to take a lot of water. We're going to mount up. Our crew is a bunch of suspicious alcoholics. So that's a thing to be concerned about. Alright, we found the skeleton of what must have been a British explorer. They carried an awful lot of crates deep into this cave. I don't know if this is a great idea. Okay, sure. Bullets and rope. That's actually, painting a fairly grim picture, but we certainly have better sense than to fall into that. He said to the group of paranoid alcoholics. So, I don't know who's more worth promoting. It's actually probably, they won't want me to do this. I don't think we can afford the superstition-based morale hit. Yeah, traveling through deserts is the same as traveling through open fields if you have both water and the perk. That's pretty fantastic. I think upgrading her is going to be better for our total sanity, because we only get his bonus once per animal, but we'd get her bonus several times, or once per fight even, and then several times per fight. Seems like a pretty good one. So we have a rock overhang here. We could stop and rest, but I actually want to fill sanity with liquor to help help fight off the disloyalty. I would love to make a trade with a shaman for some cleansing. Alright, so we're looking for a village to start. Let's try to find this village, get a hold of the idol, before we do any defiling of shrines or anything. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, it's just a waterfall. Alright, loyalty increased for all of you. I do not want to hit the shrine until after we have been to the village. Also, maybe it's unwise, but I want to fight some raptors. Go. Travel. Oh, it's a single raptor. Well, shoot, this will be trivial then. Battlecat, handle him. Yeah. I guess I'll just dismount. Yeah, so the answer to the question, is a battle tiger really worth all the trouble of getting 15 animal teeth? Answer is an emphatic yes. Really yes, a lot yes. Man, I wish I'd used the stone circle. I just didn't want my party freaking out on me. It's so weird that we're only seeing one enemy at a time in these fights. Take all. Drop this. I don't actually know how the loyalty system works. It's possible that I'm buffing their loyalty beyond what is useful, not getting maximum value on things, which would be upsetting, to be sure. Oh, hey, mummies. Free mummies. And also jewels. Unfortunately, that puts me in a little bit of a position. We could cook and eat the meat we have on hand. We don't have enough, or we're not missing enough sanity to make the whiskey, to make drinking the whiskey efficient. We can toss the ropes, actually. We're not that likely to need a bunch of ropes. Alright, well, we'll maybe come back. Nope. Raptor wants to rumble? No, he doesn't. He changed his mind. And we found the Golden Pyramid. Out of curiosity. Moonstones? One. Alright. Good to know. Good to know. So we have to find that village, though. We could... Is there a hill anywhere really convenient? I think from all of these hills, we've already seen everything. There must be, like, a real area down there. Alright, let's head in that direction. Oh, they got the drop on us. Crap. Oof. This is really gonna hurt. I tried to stop in time, and it didn't. It just didn't. It elected not to. Okay, so let's do this. Shotgun power blast. Awesome. And what's going to be the best way to do this? We'll take the quick shot here. You have 7. So there's nothing we can do to kill him. We may as well just throw fangs. And then gain a tactical advantage. Alright. They don't have that many dice. Oh, and he rolled a blank even. Okay. Yeah, this sucks because our standing is all screwed up now because we had to fight all these animals to stay alive. As always, I'm going to try to hold off on using the medical supplies until we actually need to. Actually, hold up. It just struck me that I didn't really have a good view of the land around that. Okay. These things are interesting. A long-forgotten pathway led to a small patch of grass by the water body. It was so deep that we could not catch a glimpse at the bottom. Let us look into it at night. During a paranormal occurrence, a ghost appeared, hovering over the surface of the water. He told us of a hidden region surrounded by colossal mountains. It was said that due to its isolated location, the region was still host to prehistoric animals. Alright, I want to do Dinosaur Land, for sure. Let's eat some meat really quick here. Oh, I didn't level her. Shoot, I was totally going to. Also, why do we have... Did we have, like, a stack plus one? And then I just cooked off the big stack because I'm an idiot. Hopefully our wounds will heal naturally pretty soon. Okay, his wound is festering. It is definitely time to heal him. There we go. And let us explore this place. Refill our water. Rest. Morale was bad and the opportunity for conflict aplenty. I overheard Laurette Couillard making a witty remark about the Queen. Captain Robert Ninnis saw it as an affront and demanded an apology, which he did not get. Neither one of them seems to be particularly disloyal. We're just going to let it slide. She's more important to the group than you are. Sorry, buddy. It's just kind of the way things are. Alright, let's go ahead and go. That was enough for us to push on bravely for a while. And, you know, we can do this. Damn it. Spend the points. Just stop screwing up. Alright, I do appreciate that the game is actually taking the, infected wound. My own wound is infected. Alright, nobody's stuff is healing naturally. Extend my vision. Okay. That's a lot of, potential stuff here. Alright, we are at 15 sanity per meat. That's actually really great. We need to import these animals. Well, I mean, I got the meat from, like, a whole bunch of different kinds of animals, though. Alright, let's rest overnight at this oasis, I guess. We'll refill water and rest overnight. Uh-oh, that night we witnessed an occurrence of unspeakable horror. With a frightful moan and crash, one of our mummified samples smashed out from its crate. It twitched and shambled toward us. This is actually kind of good for us. Not that the mummy's a total pushover, although he really does not have that much health. Oh man, are you kidding me? Actually, this is still good enough? It is not. Shoot. We didn't roll gun at all. You know what? Bullet. Whew, sanity. Take all. So that was actually kind of helpful. We don't have any real reason to wait a second time now. Also, it bugs me that it creates new stacks of things instead of just settling up the old stack. Alright, let's head over here. Get into a fight with some hyenas if we can. Okay, infected wounds, not that great. Yeah, sure. Yeah, Battlecat is killing everything. He's so good at his job. Alright, I didn't use the med kit right away because I wanted to see if she was going to get injured again during that battle. And she didn't. So now, unfortunately, this has turned out to be another damn oasis. And we are actually not at all sure where the village for the quest might be. That's not good. Well, let's go fight a giant bird for sanity, because that's what happens when you fight to the death with a giant bird. You get more sane. Okay, this is not super great, this roll. There we go, that's a little better. So first of all, point blank. Secondly, fierce claws. He has 7 left. It's this thing is Ripper Leap, and then Quick Shot and Bite. And we have no standing left, by the way. We over-meated a little bit there, so we had to drop some. And then I think it's the Hyena Pelts? All this other stuff is more valuable. Could be the shovels. Could be the dynamite. It's the shovels. Yeah, we'll go ahead and level you up too. So his red die became a strong red die. I like that. Well, let's go down here. Yeah, just verifying that these actually are dead ends. Man, crud. That's what I have to say about this. And we're running out of time. Well, I guess we go back. We just couldn't find a village to take an idol from. So let's go back by way of this shrine then. So we will cook and eat one meat. We will travel the distance that allows us to travel. Actually, would it be beneficial? Probably. Let's stop over here. I guess we're not arriving before anybody else anyway. So we may as well actually rest. There was turmoil in the group. Lorette Couillard pointed at a vulture that was flying overhead. According to her, this is a bad omen. Okay, shoot it, whatever. Lorette was evidently relieved. And we got a meat. Also, it says she was relieved, but she didn't actually gain any loyalty, so I'm a little annoyed. Oh, hey, no, leave. And we're starting to have loyalty problems on account of a lack of whiskey. You know, it does seem like desert regions are just more difficult, like the good stuff in them doesn't spawn very often. We're not seeing a lot of villages, obviously, but they just seem to be more spread out, and the structure showed long cracks, but it seemed safe enough to explore. You guys are both superstitious and angry. Whatever. They're already angry. Oh, and we needed a moonstone. We actually did not have a moonstone. Huge mountains erupted from the ground. I thought long cracks was the chasms. This is fine. We can get out of here. We have to not be so overburdened, though. So, the water, probably. We don't actually have to cross too much desert to get out of here anymore. And maybe we cook some of the meat and then toss the rest? Or no, we'll toss a bullet, for sure. We are still cooking some of the meat. Alright, well, let's travel some safe distance. Hopefully the angry people won't kill each other on the way there. Man, think about it. If we met a Beastmaster now, we could get a second Battlecat. Also, it's a good thing we brought dynamite, or we might actually not be able to get out of here if we hadn't dynamited that mountain earlier. We may as well. Are you running away from us? My tiger is judging you. That's what's happening right now. Right, Ripper Leap. And victory. And sanity. And meat. Which we will cook and discard. This is worth 20 funds back home. You know what? At this point we could throw the dynamite out. It's only 10 worth of dynamite. Or let's throw out the red mushroom. Because the red mushrooms really are a lot worse than medkits. Alright, so a pretty slow expedition that resulted in a lot of stuff that's worth funds and not so much with the, fame, unfortunately. We'll just fast forward through that. We know what that says. So we could go occult vision, we could be ruffians, we could get better at dynamiting stuff. I think I'm going to take ruffian, actually. I don't usually take these things and give an extra die. But we're fighting an awful lot. Yeah, us not getting a speed bonus at all really hurt. Let's keep these for trade. Gift that to reclaim our rightful lead. Keep all these for trade. These skins actually have a higher funds value, a higher worth in funds than their value. So we sell three of these. This could be either or. We sell these. These we keep. This gets gifted. This we just go ahead and sell. And that we keep. Okay, well that's going to be it for this episode. We actually get our choice of deserts on this next expedition. A bunch of them. Alright, we'll see what we do. Come back next time. We're going to wrap up this expedition, hopefully chalk up our first golden frame in a while, and maybe, finally, actually get out of here with a dinosaur in tow. And we'll see you then.